Hello friends, welcome to this session. So in this session we will study this topic, bond dissociation enthalpy, or we can say bond enthalpy. It is written in a symbolic form, delta H bond. So what is the bond dissociation enthalpy? So during the formation of a bond, potential energy of the atoms, it decreases and the energy is released. So this released energy or change in enthalpy when a bond is formed from an isolated gaseous atom is called as bond enthalpy. So this is the definition. See examples. So this is the hydrogen atoms in gaseous state, hydrogen atom. So this is a neutral atom. So when they will combine, so they will release some energy in formation of hydrogen gas. So this is the formation of this hydrogen molecule, and this much energy release. So this is your exothermic energy. On the other hand, we can also define, so bond cleavage needs energy, and the change in enthalpy when a said bond is broken into isolated gaseous atom is called as the bond dissociation enthalpy. Or we can say, speak like this also. Amount of energy required to break one mole of a bond of a particular type between the atoms in the gaseous state, that is, to separate the atoms in the gaseous state under one atmospheric pressure and at a specified temperature. This is also called as the bond dissociation enthalpy. You can see this hydrogen, once you will break, so it will convert into this neutral atoms. So this is the amount of energy. If you take reverse one, that is called heat of formation, then in that case this will be your negative. Cleavage of Cl2 into this, again positive, so this is the endothermic. Cleavage of HCl, again you can see positive energy, so this is again your endothermic. So in diatomic molecules, what happened? Bond enthalpy and bond dissociation energies are same in magnitude in diatomic molecules. For example, H2, if you take, this is the energy 435.14, and if you take this one, half means single molecule, then this energy will be your half of delta H. And bond enthalpy, HS bond is between the two hydrogen bond, will be nothing but the 2 into enthalpy of formation of neutral atom. In polyatomic molecules, what I mean, the sum same type of covalent bond may be required different energy for cleavage. So here we are discussing same type of covalent bond. See, for example, dissociation of OH bond in water, H2O. Actually, H2O contains two bond. H2O contains two bond. One is the H, O and H. So for this one, energy will be different. For this one, energy will be different. Let us see. So this is the HOH. So it is split into neutral atoms and OH. So for this one, delta H1, this one. And again, for next one, so we require the delta H2, 423.28. So total will be how much? H2H converted to this one, 2H neutral atoms and oxygen. Dissociation of this one, H2O. So you have to add this thing and you will get the finally this one. So in this case, what happened? A molecule contains two more covalent bonds in between same atoms. And bond cleavage involves different amount of energy. Then average value of the dissociation energy of a given bond is taken. So in this case, we will take the average. This is nothing but the, we will say this is the average bond energy. It's not the bond, this is the average bond energy. So this average bond dissociation energy is required to break each bond in a compound is called as the bond energy. So the difference is many. So average bond energy is nothing but the total energy required for the cleavage of all the bonds divided by total number of bonds broken. So average bond energy for water, delta H1 plus delta H2 by 2. So add this one and you will get the average bond enthalpy of the OH bond. Similarly, for polyatomic molecules like methane, the thermochemical equation for this atomization reaction means we are converting to atom. So it is atomization reaction. So heat of atomization for this CH4 is nothing but the 1660 kilojoule per mole. So the heat of atomization means converting to atom state. So here we have, in this case here, methane has CH bond. Four CH bonds are identical in bond length and energy. However, energy required to bring the individual CH atoms in each successive steps are different. So which are these? Okay, let us see. This is CH4. So if one CH bond is broken, it becomes CH3 dot atom gas in gas state and H dot. So for this one, 426. Second, it will be broken. So you will get the, again, this energy different. Third, you will break. So you will get the this much energy. And fourth, you will break. You will get the this one. Then heat of atomization for this will be different. For CH is again different. So all these are experimental value. So experimentally, the delta H is this much. So average bond energy of the CH, that is the bond, will be how much? So total energy divided by 4 kilojoule per mole, so you will get the 415 kilojoule per mole. So this is the average bond enthalpy of CH. So we cannot find the bond energy of CH directly. We have to find like this step. It should be noted that the average value does not necessarily match the energy of any one of the individual bonds. Hence, the bond dissociation energy is a measure of bond strength. Also, this is a bond dissociation enthalpy. So, when it is increased high, then what happens? Bond strength also increases. For example, pi bonds have high bond dissociation energy than sigma bonds, because pi bonds contains of this one, and there are 1 pi bonds and sigma bonds. So this is definitely energy will be higher than that of sigma bonds. But if you take the single bond, the single bond of pi is always lesser than that of sigma. But if you take the combined, then the number of bonds is more, so energy will be more. What are the factors that affect the bond energy? So just we have seen that if multiple bonds are there, the bond energy will be max. So one is the multiple bonds. Size of the atom. So if it's atoms having the smaller size, so it will form a shorter and a more stronger bonds, as the smaller orbitals very close to nuclei, the orbitals are very close, so they are overlapping more effectively. So the such atoms form the they form the bonds with higher bond energy. For example, Cl, Br and I. So this one, definitely the size of Cl is more smaller, so bond enthalpy of Cl is higher than Br than Ca. But in case of halogen, bond enthalpy of Cl is more greater than the fluorine. So in case of Cl2, if you see experimentally, Cl2 having a 254 kilojoule per mole and fluorine having the 155 kilojoule per mole. So why this size of the fluorine is smaller, but it has a less bond enthalpy, so it should be opposite. In this case, there is exception, because there is a high degree of repulsion of lone pair of electrons and fluorine. There is a high degree of repulsion of lone pair of electrons fluorine due to smaller size. So in this case, electrons repel to each other in case of fluorine. So that's why its bond enthalpy of fluorine is lesser than that of Cl2. So this is one of the exceptions you have to keep in mind. Next is your electronegativity. So bond formed between atoms having large difference in their electronegativity has high polarity and so have more ionic character. Means if the bond polarity is high, bond strength will be higher. For example, HF, HO, HN. So in case you can see, this is the electronegative is 2.1, in case of 4. So difference is 1.9. Similarly, this will be difference will be 1.4.9. So high polarity in this case, so energy will be, bond energy will be high. Less polarity, energy will be low. So this is what I mean to say that. Next point is bond length. Shorter the bond length, higher is the bond enthalpy. Similarly, bond energy also depends upon the number of bondings that we have seen it. So triple bond has more energy, double bond has lesser, and followed by single bond has lesser. But sigma bond is stronger than the pi bond. In this table, you can see bond enthalpy of some compounds. So this side is your bond. So this is the energy, and this is the bond of this different atoms. So this is the average bond enthalpy. So just you can pause this video and you can compare it. So it will be convenient. So this is the average single bond enthalpy of different atoms. So this is the bond enthalpy for hydrogen 4. It is 34. 36. So this is the hydrogen. So hydrogen, hydrogen this much, carbon, hydrogen this much. So this is the one way, and this is the average multiple bond enthalpy of different atoms. So it is easy to compare. So after pausing video, you can easily understand. And then this is the calorific value of different type of fuel or food. So there, here you can understand. And this is the substance whose heat of combustion is given. So by comparing these things, you will easily understand which are requiring less, which are requiring more. Application of bond enthalpies. So it has many applications to determine the heat of reaction. We can find heat of formation, heat of combustion, resonance energy, heat of transitions. All we can find through this bond application of bond. So let us see how we can find it. So this is for heat of formation, heat of reaction. Sorry. So bond energy used for determining heat of reaction means heat of reaction will be bond energy of the reactant, means this energy used for breaking the bonds, and the summation of the bond energy of the product. So this energy used for the formation of bond. So for exothermic, heat of energy will be reactant will be more than that of product, and for endothermic it will be less than that of product. So this is example. So CH2Cl2 is converting this atom. So this is what is the heat of reaction. So for this CH we know that this much, Cl we know that this much. So use this formula: bond energy of the reactant minus bond energy of the product. So for product, so this is the atom, so it will be zero because all is solid state. Okay, so all will be zero. This is zero. This will be gaseous. So only we have to break the bond this side. So product is zero. Take the only reactant side. So CH is 2CH is there. 2 into there 2Cl, so 2 into this energy and 2 into this energy. So if you solve it, you will get this much value. Next is, this is the ethene gas. So in ethene gas, hydrogenation is taking place, so it will form an ethane. So again, enthalpy heat of reaction will be this enthalpy of reaction, bond enthalpy of reactant minus bond enthalpy of product. So it has one double bond and 4 CH bond in this case, and the heat of hydrogen is hydrogen has one, this one. In this case, there is a 2 CC bonds and 6 CH bonds. So values are given. Substitute the value, so you will get minus 30 kilocalorie. Similarly, this is the chlorination of methane to form CH3Cl and HCl. So what is the heat of reaction of this compound? So CHCl, CLCl, all values are given in kilojoule per mole. Again, same formula, heat of reaction is nothing but the bond enthalpy of reactant minus bond enthalpy of product. So 4 into heat of enthalpy of CH minus again Cl2 is given. And minus, this is the reactant, this is the product. So product is 3 into enthalpy of CH, bond energy of CH, plus enthalpy of Cl, and similarly energy of the HCl. So right here, H is I have forgotten, of HCl. So taking the value from here, substitute the value. If you solve it, you will get minus 115 kilojoule per mole. Determination of heat of formation of compound. So already we have seen the definition. Heat of formation compound, nothing but the half H2 in gaseous form, Cl2 forms to make the 1 mole of the compound. And enthalpy of hydrogen Cl is given over here, that is kilocalorie per mole. So again, the formula will be same. Delta H of reaction, this is nothing but the reactant, sum of the reactant minus sum of the enthalpy of the product. So in this we can see energy will be 1/2 molecules. We'll take half of enthalpy of H. Cl, so again, we have to require half only. So this is the missing. So this is half of energy of the Cl, and this is the 1 mole. So for H like this side and for Cl like this, you will get this value. So next question, this is the reaction of ammonia. So we have to find the heat of formation of ammonia. Data are given in kilojoule per mole. Again, same formula, heat of reaction minus enthalpy of product. So ammonia is 2 nitrogen and this is 3 into hydrogen enthalpy, and minus, so this is the 3 NH bond. So 3 into 2, 6. So 6 into delta H into NH. So NH value is given. Now substitute the value NN, nitrogen, hydrogen, and 3 value of ammonia. So 3 into 6, subtract it, you will get this one. So this is the heat of formation of the ammonia. So if you this is the two molecules of ammonia, so you have to keep in mind. So if you want to found heat formation is for one ammonia molecule, for heat formation is nothing but the for one ammonia molecule. So you have to take the total value divided by two. So if you divide it, this is the heat formation of one molecule of ammonia. Next, we have to calculate the find the resonance energy. So resonance energy is defined as the heat of formation of the compound is the experimental value. Means this you have to take from the experiment, and again heat of formation from the standard value, calculated value. So this is theoretical. So this is given, and theoretical value you have to calculate from the bond energy or bond enthalpy data. This you have to calculate. This is given. Let us see example. Calculate the resonance energy of N2O from data. So heat of formation of N2 nothing but the N2 plus half O2 will give you N2O, and these are the values is given, theoretical value. So heat of reaction nothing but the summation of the heat of reactant plus summation of the heat of product. Heat of reactant means 2 nitrogen and half hydro enthalpy of the oxygen, half minus. So N2O, N2O means if you see the compound N2O, this is the N2O Lewis structure of the N2O. So in this we can see there is a one NN bond and one NO bond. So enthalpy of NO, enthalpy of NH. Now substitute the value, and substituting you will get this much energy. So what is the resonance energy? So resonance energy is the experimental value minus calculated value. So experimental value is given, this is the experimental value and this is the theoretical value. So H2 minus 170, you will get the, this is the resonance energy of the compound. Calculate the resonance energy of the benzene from using KQL structures. So heat of formation of C6H6 experimentally given, and heat of atomization of carbon from solid state to gas is also given, and for other heat enthalpy is given, CH, this is the set kilojoule per mole. So heat of formation of this benzene is this one, experimentally this one. So we have to find the resonance energy. So resonance energy is nothing but the heat of formation experimental value minus calculated value. So first we have to calculate the value, heat of formation. So in this we can see carbon is there. So carbon is kind of solid state. First we have to convert to gaseous state, then it will react. So for gaseous state there are 6 carbon. So this is given value 716.1 for one carbon atom. So heat of atomization for this carbon will be this much value. And 3 hydrogen, so 3 into energy of the hydrogen is this much enthalpy minus C6H6. So this is the benzene structure. So if you see the structure, the structure will be like this. Already we know that. So in this there are 3 double bonds, and you can see 3 single bonds, 3 CH bonds, 6 CH bonds. So this is, again we can see attached with the hydrogen. So in this way we have 6 CH bonds and 3 double bonds and 3 CH bonds. So substituting the value, you will get the experimental value, that is this much. So resonance energy will be how much? So experimental value is 358 minus theoretical value. On solving, you will get the 150 kilojoule per mole. So just try yourself this to calculate the resonance energy of carbon dioxide. So heat of this is atomization for carbon is given this much. Heat of combustion for this CO2 is given 393 plus kilojoule, and heat of atomization of carbon is given this much. Cu and O bond enthalpy is given. If you solve it, so you will get the answer this much. Just you try by yourself. Determine the heat of combustion. Okay, so this is the ethene gas reacting with the oxygen to give CO2 in water. So all energy is given. So heat of combustion for this reaction will be again same formula, summation of reactant by the summation enthalpy of the product. So there is a CC bonds and there is a 4 hydrogen bonds plus the 1 more oxygen over, and minus CO2 plus H2O. For CO2 again there is a 2 CO bonds, so 2 into 2 4, because 2 is written here, and H2O, so there is a 2 OH bonds, so 2 into 2 again 4. So like the bond enthalpy value of this one, so on solving you will get minus 1964 kilojoule per mole. So just you calculate it, you will get this much value. Next, to calculate the bond enthalpy between atoms, so this CaCl4 is converted to gas and Cl gas. So this is the converted to atomization state. So this is a bond atomization actually. Then we have to find the bond enthalpy of Cl, CCl in CCl4. So what is the bond enthalpy of Cl? This we have to find out. And the heat of evaporation of CCl4 is given this much. Heat of formation of CCl4 is given this much. And atomization of carbon this much. And atomization of Cl2 is given 242. Means CCl4 is converted from solid to gas is this much. From solid to from solid of carbon to Cl with reacting with the Cl2 gas, CCl4 is this much. So this is the heat of evaporation. Heat of this one. Then again carbon from solid to gas is heat of sublimation this much, and Cl2 is converted to Cl gas, the heat of atomization 242 kilojoule per mole. So CCl4 gas is converted to C gas and Cl gas. So this is the heat of atomization. So what is heat energy required? So to find this one, so we have to reverse this equation first. Means carbon plus 2 Cl2 in gaseous form will give you CCl4. We have to find the heat of formation. So once we know this value, we can calculate the bond enthalpy of CCl4. So heat of formation is equal to heat of reaction minus heat of product. So for carbon is given heat of atomization from solid to gas is this much, and 2 into Cl2 is given this much, and heat of evaporation of CCl4. So first we have to convert solid into gas, and again heat of formation of CCl is also given this much value. So if you add all this value from this data, you can see carefully, so you will get 1304 kilojoule per mole. So this is the heat of formation of CCl4. So what is the this is a bond. We have to find the CCl bond. So this is the total energy, and there are four bonds in the CCl4. So divide the total energy by 4, so you will get the 324 kilojoule per mole. Similarly, we have another questions same manner. So calculate the CC bond. So this is the reaction. C is reacting with the H2, giving C2H6. Delta H is given this much, and heat of atomization of this one, and enthalpy of CH4 is CH is given this kilojoule per mole. So we will take the heat of this whole enthalpy is nothing but the bond energy of the reactant minus bond energy of the product. So reactant is nothing but, if you see carefully, carbon heat of atomization of carbon is 2 into heat of atomization of carbon, because it's converting to solid to gas. Again for hydrogen, 3 into enthalpy of atomization of hydrogen minus product is your C2H6. C2H6 means that there is a 6 CH bond and 1 CC bond. So substitute this value. On substituting and solving, and delta H is already given experimental value, that is heat of formation. So substitute this value. On solving, you will get the this bond energy is not given, so write as it is. So you will get for this value 329.77 kilojoule per mole. Heat of atomization of PH3 is given this much, and heat of atomization of P2OH4 is given 355 kilocalorie per mole. Calculate the bond energy of the PP. So how we calculate? So PH3 is given. So delta H is nothing but the bond enthalpy of reactant minus the bond enthalpy product. So first you split the value. Heat of so phosphine will convert it to phosphorus plus 3 hydrogen into gaseous state. Similarly, P2H4 is converted to 2P into 4H. So if you add this one and subtract it, so on adding, PH3 plus P2H4 is a reactant, and this is the product. So for this is 0, because this is in gaseous form and elementary form. So we will take the only bond energy of the this whole molecule, and product will be 0. So in this case, there is a 4PH, how 4PH, and there is a 1 PP bonds. If you solve it, you will get this much. There is a 4 pH, there is 1 PP, and enthalpy is given 355, already given here over. We will take P2H4 only. We are talking this one from 2. So not PH3, we will take only this one. So on taking this one, the PP is how much? So PP we don't know. This value we know, that is 228 by 3. So this 228 is taken from PH3 value. And on solving, so delta H of PP is nothing but 355 minus 4 into this much value, you will get the 51 kilocalorie per mole. In solid ammonia, each ammonia has 6 molecules at the nearest neighbors, and heat of solution ammonia is 30.8 kilojoule per mole. And heat of solution means in the absence of hydrogen bonding, this is the sublimation. And what is the strength of the hydrogen bond in solid ammonia? So in absence of hydrogen bonding, this energy in the presence of is something different. So heat of in absence, this much energy. This is the energy for heat of absence, in absence of hydrogen bonding. This is the heat of in absence of presence of this energy in presence of hydrogen bonding. So what is the total strength of the hydrogen bonds? So in presence of this much energy and in absence this much energy. If you subtract it, so you will get this much energy, and this energy nothing but the bond of hydrogen, energy of the hydrogen bond present in ammonia, in which it has six ammonia is surrounded by this solid state. Because in like other state, it is there is no hydrogen bonding. So there are six nearest neighboring ammonia molecules, and each hydrogen bond involves the two molecules. So number of hydrogen bond will be 6 by 2, 3. So the strength of each hydrogen bond will be this total energy by 3. So 5.5 joule per mole. Estimate the sulfur SF bond energy in SF6. So heat of formation SF6 is given minus 1100. Fluorine is atomization given this much. And heat of evaporation sublimation is for sulfur is given this much. Now SF6 is converting S and F6 fluorine, and for this again energy is given enthalpy again 1855 kilojoule. So heat of formation of this is nothing but the reactant minus product. In product, this solid is converted to gas, and heat of atomization of fluorine also given. So for sulfur there is 6 delta H into SF, and for soil into gas, heat of atomization for this 2 is given. 275 for fluorine given 80. So this heat of formation again experimentally is given how much, that is the 1100. So this is the heat of formation, and this is the reverse of SF6. So we'll take the positive value and put the value of 6 into delta HSF, and this is given. So on solving, what will happen, so you will get this much value. Similarly, this is the example of polymerization. So ethene is polymerized into this much. So this is the heat of polymerization. So this molecule is converted into this form. And what is the heat of polymerization? So CC is given this much, and double bond for single bond is given this much. So now in this you can see if one single bond is splitting, they are forming two double bonds. One is this side, one is this side. So we can say N double bonds forms a molecule with 2N single bonds. So we have to take these steps. Heat of polymerization means heat of polymerization will be bond enthalpy of reactant minus bond enthalpy of product. So in bond enthalpy, how many bonds are there? So bond will be N into N bonds. This is delta H. And in this case, 2N is extra. So 2N divided by this N. Because this is 2N divided by N. So 2N by N, and then delta H into single bonds. So for this energy will be this much, and this in this case 2 bond extra, so 2 into 331, you will get this much kilojoule per mole.